not throw people's mental illnesses in their face when you're having a fight with them. Hey everybody, so it is May 5th, right? Yeah, May 5th, 2020 at 12:17 in the morning. And I make a video like late at night because I have something to say. So this is kind of like a personal thing that's like happened to me, but also like I know I'm not the only one that this has happened to, so I would like to speak about it and like spread awareness so that this like doesn't happen. Okay, cool. So basically, this has happened twice in my life. One, literally like this weekend. For those of you that don't know me, hi, my name is Rylan, and I make videos about mental illness and transgender stuff because I'm trans, but this is about mental health. So I talk openly on my channel about how I struggle with a lot of mental health diagnoses, you know, 8 or 9 or 10, depends how open I want to be with somebody, but yeah, that's what's going on up here. So I've got some stuff going on, okay? And here's what's up. I, two specific people in my life, who I didn't know very well. One of them was this girl that I was like talking to, and then this other girl was a friend. Bitch, she's not a friend. She's not a friend. Who I met like 2 months ago. Both of these people disclosed that I had some mental health conditions. Now I'll use this last girl because this is the most like recent thing that I can reference. Like, I don't remember what I told the other girl, but I will just call her Becky because that's a basic bitch's name and that's who this girl is because she's rude. Okay. So her name is Becky. If your name is Becky, you're not a basic bitch. I feel bad. Like just, okay. Her name is Jessica. So Jessica, and I started talking and like, I don't know. I have learned in my life from ruining relationships by disclosing my mental health conditions too soon can often scare people away, especially when it comes to the symptoms that are associated with borderline personality disorder, just to name a few, suicidal ideation, actions and behavior, such as maybe self-harm, attachment issues, abandonment issues, maybe like coming off like too clingy or something like that. Mood swings, stuff like that. So those are like main symptoms of borderline that can really fuck up relationships, especially when it comes to feelings of abandonment, because sometimes people with borderline think that someone's gonna leave them when they're not. But these feelings are very, sounds like there's a plow outside, are very real to us in the time that they're happening. So in my younger years, I used to just like kind of give people a caveat like, hey, I have borderline, like I might become obsessed with you and then hate you. Okay, that's called splitting. So that'll come into play later. So that's something that I learned, is to not disclose my mental health problems like right away when I meet someone because they run away and they judge you and then things like this happened. So basically, I ended up talking to this girl and we ended up, I was trying to grow as a human being and tell her like, hey, something you said to me like a month ago, like offended me, because confrontation is not something I like and, you know, I'm working on it. And basically she just ended up going in on me, and literally the first sentence that she said to me was, I know that you're dealing with or something, like, I get that you have your whole he/she thing. And I was like, why are you bringing up my gender identity? And basically just went on to say how benevolent she was in dealing with me because of my mental health. She literally said that, like, having mental illness, like, wasn't an excuse for, like, being rude, and said that I was entitled or something, because I did not use the borderline excuse. I didn't say the reason I didn't say anything to you and the reason that I drew back and stopped talking to you was because of my mental health symptoms. She said something that was offensive to me, and I ended up, like, not talking to her and for, like, a month, just being very cold, because I split on her. And splitting just means that it's very black and white thinking with people, that we can either like adore someone and put them on the highest pedestal and think that they're absolutely amazing, and then perhaps if they do something wrong that hurts us, offend us, whatever, invalidates us, whatever, that we end up going on the complete opposite extreme and just like exiling this person and like hating their guts. Not exactly the most conducive to healthy and long-lasting relationships, but it happens, and people that matter will stick around for that. But yeah, she ended up just like throwing my mental illness in my face. I don't really remember what she said, and I'm glad that I don't, because I'm hoping that my brain is honestly protecting me and like not remembering all the offensive things that she said. But here's what's unfair about the situation is, I never went into detail about any of the mental health conditions that I had. I might have named, like, yeah, I struggle with, like, bipolar, you know, anxiety, maybe even mentioned that I had PTSD. I don't know. But I never went into, like, the whole entire, like, 9-tier list and explained all of the symptoms like I do on my YouTube. I didn't do that. It was very, very minimal. So for her to throw this in my face when I was literally saying, like, hey, I've been cold to you and I wanted to apologize because I realized that's not fair. I want to give you a second chance. She literally said at one point during the text, like, honestly, like, I'm grateful that you did this because, like you warned me or something like that. Like, thanks for the warning or something. So basically she just threw my mental health problems into an equation that had no reason to be in the equation. And then I did try explaining what splitting was and even took like a little screenshot of like Psychology Today. And I said, I didn't want to bring this in, but like, this is part of a mental health issue. And she literally just typed no. And then went in on like how, you know, my mental health wasn't allowed to inform my behavior, when in fact she didn't know anything about me. We really didn't know each other that well. And then the other person that this happened with, we were like talking to each other, and I mean talking to each other like romantically-ish. And she ended up saying when we stopped talking that she didn't want to date someone that had, I don't know what number she used, 22, 50, something dramatic. I don't want to date someone with 50 mental illnesses. And it's like, again, like, I never even let you into that part of my life. The people that know those things about me are people that are in my immediate surrounding and YouTube, because I talk about it. But for people to like really see the nitty-gritties of how my mental health affects me, like, you have to be in like one of the 5 people that I actually talk to. So I don't let strangers or people that I'm talking to romantically or people that, like, you know, I've known for 2 months know about. So I would just like to say, to now take the story away from me, is how fucked up that is, and how, like, let's not ever do that. The closest comparison I can make that to is, because if we look at mental illness, it's a biological thing. It's inherent and you can't control it. It's, you didn't choose it. You know what I mean? It's just like part of you. So a lot of people like to invalidate mental illness and say that it's not real or whatever because you can't see it. And then a lot of people will equate, you know, mental illness with cancer. Well, would you tell someone with cancer, you know, just get over it, stop being tired, or whatever? I'm saying this because for some reason, that's the example that people always use. Or like, if someone has a cold, well, get over it, just like blow your nose and rest. Well, that's not the same with depression. You can't just go tell someone to stop being sad and then magically you're cured. Are you with me? I hope this is making sense. What I'm trying to say is, the equivalent of throwing someone's mental health into a fight, discussion, disagreement, breakup, whatever, is essentially like saying to someone that has cancer, like when you guys are like breaking up in like a huge like debacle or something, or what this was is like the ending of talking, a friendship, a relationship, anything, because that is toxic and I don't need that in my life. But that's like someone throwing at someone else like, well, fuck you for having cancer because I never liked it when you had chemo and you were throwing up all the time and the fact that your hair was falling out was so annoying and was a nuisance to me. Like, you would never do that. You wouldn't say that to someone. You wouldn't, like, say something horrible to someone that had, like, diabetes or something like that. Like, well, you and your fucking insulin shots are annoying as hell. Like, you wouldn't say that. So, like, why would someone else attack someone else's other areas of health? It just happens to be, like, health up here instead of, like, you know, bodily and accepted by the world. So I just like, let's stop. Cause I know I'm not the only one that this happens to. And it's just, it's really unbalanced. It's fucked up and it's unfair because why would anyone like, that's just like a really low, that's a really low dig to throw something in someone's face that they have no control over. I don't know. I think that's really messed up, and you could apply that to a lot of things. You can apply, I mean, like cancer, like blah blah blah, you have chemo, or if someone happens to be in a chair, like, well, why can't you walk? Why would you say that? So yeah, I just like to put it out there that let's find other ways to be mean to each other that don't attack other people's mental health. If you want to say that, I don't know, someone hogs the remote too much or they never clean the bathroom, like do that, but don't attack the fact that I have chemical imbalances in my brain that cause issues in my life. And especially if it's someone that I don't know and they have the audacity to bring that up, no. Is all I have to say. And I will leave this video with something that I always like to think of. Two things. One of them has to more do so with gossip. And that is, when you talk about me, it says more about you. So I think that's important. If people are talking shit behind your back, don't worry about it. It's saying more about Janice over there who's talking shit about you. But number two, what's important in this situation is, like if someone's trying to bring you down, you're already above them. You're more evolved than them because you wouldn't do that to someone else. So that's not what I'm telling myself. It's literally just the truth. I would never say that to somebody. I would never. I'll yell at my girlfriend about not doing the dishes. I would never make fun of or throw in her face the fact that she struggles with depression because that's disgusting. So PSA, rant, advice, all of it rolled in to one. I hope this helped someone. I don't know. Anyway, take it easy, y'all, and I'll see you soon.